Good morning, everybody. Once again, we met to continue our lesson. You know already what we are discussing about playing with magnets. Playing with magnets. So in that, we discussed a lot of things. I think at last class, what we finished, you recall that how to magnetize, how to make the magnets, how we made by using what process? Magnetization process, the process we used to make one magnets. What is the magnetization process? In that magnetization process, what type of we used? So the one is a single touch method. Single touch method, and another one was double touch method. Double touch method, and third one by sending electric current is electrical method. Electrical method. Those are the ways to magnetize the magnetic materials. Those are the ways to magnetize the magnetic materials. So by this magnetization process, we prepared but two type of magnets. One is a temporary magnets, one is a permanent magnets. Temporary magnets and another one is a permanent magnets. So permanent magnets we utilize it by using what? Electrical method. Okay, electrical method. Okay, those are what we finished in our past class to recall. Okay, then one some more you may recall. But now we are talking about a new topic which is not your regular syllabus. So magnetic poles, already we discussed this. Magnetic poles and also dipoles. Magnetic poles and dipoles. See there, in that magnetic mechanism, when you are talking about magnet, what is the magnet we discussed about that? Magnet. The magnet means the material which is exert a magnetic force, maybe attract or repel. That is what we are saying, magnet. Okay. Coming to that, magnetic pole, rather we discuss it both by stringy iron filings or otherwise, when you are dropping magnetic materials on the surface of magnet, we may observe most of the magnetic materials will attract ends of the magnet. If you imagine this is a magnet, most of the magnetic materials is what we discussed in the substance which are attracted by the magnet. Those material we are calling as what? A magnetic material. When we are sprinkling means what is where? Okay, those magnetic material are the bar magnet or any magnet, so it will attract most of at where ends of the magnet. Otherwise, where the most of the magnetic materials are attracted by the magnet, that particular place we are saying what are poles. So the poles only having what the strongest magnetic force. Okay, most of the magnetic materials will attract at poles and the least at the center of the magnet. So coming by that, so we already discussed about what is a magnet consists a pair of poles. Magnet consists a pair of poles. Pair of poles. Pair means what? Two poles. Pair means two poles. Then see there, what are those already discussed in the last class? I given a task also to you. Is it? One is a north pole, one is a south pole. One is a north pole and one is a south pole. So, by this, how means what is the attraction force and what is the repulsion? So by different activities, we already learned about how the poles to the magnet. Then see what I'm saying to you. Suppose if you suspend means what? To hang. A marker suspended in my hand. To hang. So when you suspend a bar magnet, this is the rigid support. What is that? Rigid support. And this is the thread, and this is the ball magnet. Ball magnet. This is the thread. Okay. So rigid support, fixed support, and thread and ball magnet. See there. What happened to that? When you suspend the ball magnet, when you suspend the ball magnet, generally you know about what you know about earth. See, generally it is a circle, a spherical shape. Is it spherical shape? Yeah, that is in a spherical shape. According to India map, what you can decide? How will we discuss your goals? So, it is a Great Himalayas. This side is what? Great Himalayas. And this side is what? Hindu Ocean. Hindu Ocean. And this side is what? Bay of Bengal. And this side is what? So, Arabian Ocean or Arabian Sea. So coming to that, so this is the water. They are Bengal, they are east, right? East and Arabian west. At the same time, we have to talk about what? And Great Himalayas, they are located north. And this is south. Hindu Ocean, located at the south. So what we mean? Observe. See here, Earth is also one of the magnet. Earth is also considered as one of the magnet, huge magnet. Okay, so it is also consists a pair of poles. Earth also consists a pair of poles. Those are we are calling geographical pattern north, geographical south, geographical north. And the geography north and the south. See there, north and the south. So when you suspend that bar magnet, when you suspend that bar magnet, so it align always means it settle. The bar magnet will settle where it towards the and the north and the south direction is geographic north and the geographic south direction. The bar magnet will always choose the direction towards the earth north direction, earth south direction. Those we are calling geographic north, geographic south. The north pole of the earth is we are calling geographic north, south pole of the earth we are calling geographic south. So the bar magnet which you suspended is freely hanged. Okay, that always align towards the geographic north and geographic south. So the end, the bar magnet end, which towards the geographic north. The bar magnet end, which shows towards the geographic north. That when light poles are in contact, what you observe already discussed with parallel. Unlike poles, when it is in contact, it will attract each other. Is it or not? So this is general information about bar magnet. And we will discuss some more about bar magnet. What we will discuss some more about bar magnet? We will see that. So it has two poles already discussed. then we will talk about bar magnet. We will talk about bar magnet. Bar magnet. So what is the shape of bar magnet? What is the shape of bar magnet? Shape of bar magnet. Shape of the bar magnet is a cuboid. What is that? Cuboid. Otherwise, rectangular shape. It is three dimensional. Rectangular shape is three dimensional. See how I am going to go. This is I am saying to you what a bar magnet. What is that? Before we found water, which is south pole, which is a north pole. So I am saying to you, this is a north pole and this is a south pole. Just I am recognizing you. So those I will write that down. Write where? Write that down. See those. What I am saying to you. This is I am saying to means N and this N showing south. So S. See that what I am saying to you. These are not. This is not more like the south pole. So magnet bar magnet is made of poles. Okay. We already observed by suspender. It shows geographic north and geographic south by allowing the bar magnet with help of rigid support. Connection. At the same time, what I am talking to you, see there, the dots are located, means the poles are located just at the end. Not those are at the end. Those are, they are at just before the end. Just before the end, there is a space, no? Just before the end. Understand? See that, what you may say that the line joining, which line? This line. A line is joining to the poles of the magnet. The line which is passing horizontal to the magnet. A line which is passing through the poles of the magnet, or the line which is horizontal to the line which is passing through, or a line which is passing horizontal to the magnet, right? A line which is joining the poles. So that we are calling magnetic axis. What we are calling magnetic axis. This line we are calling magnetic axis. Magnetic axis. Otherwise, another name we can call axial line. Axial line. What are we calling? Axial line. See that? Axis of the magnet. Otherwise, we can call axis of the magnet. We can call axis of the magnet. Which is a line which is passing horizontal to the bar magnet. A line which is joining poles of the magnet. Thus we can say what axis of the magnet or magnetic axis. Otherwise, both are same with those. Otherwise, axial line. Axis of the magnet is axial line. Understand? Then coming to that, one more. What we can, a line which is passing through. A line which is passing vertical to the bar magnet, a line which is passing vertical to the bar magnet throughout the center of the magnet. This is I am saying to you, center of the magnet, center of the magnet, a line which is passing through perpendicular to the magnet, perpendicular to the magnet, vertical to the magnet, which is passing through the center of the magnet. This is a magnetic meridian. Magnetic meridian. What is that? magnetic meridian. Magnetic meridian. See that? This is only black. Only black. See what I am saying to you? Magnetic meridian. Otherwise, we can say magnetic equator. So we can say magnetic equator or magnetic equator. Magnetic equator. See there, what I am saying to you, these are the terms. Listen, we are going to learn about bar magnet. What are the parameters of the bar magnet? Understand? So, a line which is passing vertical to the bar magnet or center of the bar magnet is magnetic equator. A line which is passing horizontal to the bar magnet, that is what we are calling axis of the magnet. Okay, then we'll talk one more. What are magnetic length? What are magnetic length? Magnetic length. And which is the magnetic length? The distance between the poles of two magnets. Listen, the distance between the poles of the magnet. The distance between the poles of the magnet. See that? The distance between the poles of the magnet. The distance between the poles of the magnet is nothing but a magnetic length. The distance between the poles of the magnet. The distance between one pole to another pole, north pole to south pole, south pole to north pole, is what a magnetic length. What you are saying? Magnetic length. So magnetic length is showing by with the 2L. 2L. Magnetic length is shown by 2L because of L from the center of the magnet. Okay, in the center of the magnet, one end of the pole and another end of the pole distance is what? L. So L plus L is equal to 2L. So magnetic length is showing by 2L. And then the magnetic length where the distance between the two poles of the magnet. The distance between the two poles of the magnet. That is what is magnetic length. Then what about one more? But we said magnetic length is between the two poles of the magnet. Between the two poles. Then what about distance between the two ends of the magnet? Distance between the two ends of the magnet. Now I am saying to you, geographical length. Geographical length. What is that? Geographical length. Which is the geographical length? The distance between the two ends of the magnet. Suppose this is a magnet, bar magnet. Distance between the two ends of the magnet. Distance between the two ends of the magnet is known as geographical length. For this, what we can say? Distance between poles of the two poles. The distance between the two poles of the magnet. This is the distance between the two ends of the ends of the magnet. Distance between the two ends of the magnet. Understand? This is geographical length. Then what is the relation between geographical length and magnetic length? Relation between geographical length and magnetic length. So magnetic length is equal to So I think there is not visible. I will write. I'm going to erase this. Magnetic length is equal to 5 by 6 into geographical length. 5/6 into geographical length. Magnetic length is equal to 5/6 into geographical length. See there, magnetic length is equal to 5/6 into geographical length. Magnetic length is showing by 12. So magnetic length is equal to what I am saying, 5/6 into geographical length. So magnetic length we are showing by chart equation m. Magnetic length is equal to 5/6 into gm. It's a geographical length. You have to remember this formula, the relation between magnetic length and the geographical length. Understand? So that is to identify. Now, this is general information about those. What magnetic length is the 5/6 into. Then we will discuss one example to you, which is the geometric length of a bar magnet is 6 cm. What they are saying? Question is the geometric length of a bar magnet. So not a problem to write geographical, otherwise geometric. Geometric length of bar magnet is 6 cm. 6 cm. The distance between the two poles of the magnet is then the distance between but two poles of a magnet is. See that the geometric length of a bar magnet is 6 cm. The distance between two poles of a magnet is. The distance between what are two poles of a magnet is. What is that? How to find? See that magnetic length is equal to 5/6. Geometric length. Okay, magnetic length is equal to 5/6 in the geometric length. We have a calculation. The geometric length they are giving of a bar magnet. Geometric length means what? The distance between the two ends of the magnet. The distance between two ends of the magnet. So they are giving how much? 6 cm. The distance between two poles. The distance between two poles of a magnet. The distance between two poles of a magnet. What you may call that? The distance between two poles of the magnet is what? Magnetic length. What is that? Magnetic length. So I am going to arrange this. So what is the answer to that? We have a relation of what they are given to you? Geometric length. Given geometric length is equal to how much? The geometric length of the bar magnet. Geometric length given how much? 6 cm. Then, what the distance between two poles? Then, distance between two poles is what? When distance between two poles means we know what magnetic length. What is that? Magnetic length. I'm writing direct notation. Magnetic length is nothing as a distance between two poles. Okay. Then what again? Magnetic length is equal to 5/6 into geometric length. So magnetic length is equal to 5/6 into geometric length. They given already. Geometric length of the bar magnet is 6 cm. Six ones are. So magnetic length is equal to 5 cm. How much? 5 cm. Therefore, so the distance between the two poles is a magnetic length is 5 cm. But you can write the distance between the two poles is the distance between two poles. आपका मैग्नेट ऑफ ए मैग्नेट इज हाउ मच 5 सेंटीमीटर बट देन इट इज व्हाट द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू पोल्स ऑफ ए मैग्नेट इज व्हाट द मैग्नेट इज दैट ऑल फॉर्मड मैग्नेटिक स्क्वायर अंडरस्टैंड सो बाय दिस प्रोसेस वी कैन फाइंड व्हाट इज दैट मैग्नेटिक लेंथ बाय गिविंग मैग्नेटिक लेंथ वी कैन फाइंड ज्योमेट्रिक लेंथ By giving geometric length, we can find a magnetic length by using this formula. Understand? Then, yeah. So coming to that, what you can discuss. What is this? Pole strength. Pole strength. Pole means what? What? Pole means the more attraction or repulsion, otherwise magnetic force appears at end of the magnet. That is a pole. Strength. Strength means what? Capital or energy. This is force. Means what you can consider here, attraction or repulsion. So what is the strength of a pole that you have considered? The attraction or repulsion. The attraction or repulsion of a ends of the magnet. Okay, ends of the magnet is recognized as a pole strength. The ability of the ability is capital of the attraction is to bring close, repulsion to move of the what ends of the magnet is a pole strength. It is showing by symbol small m, small letter of the m. Which is pole strength. See that what I am saying to you, pole strength is the ability of the attraction or repulsion of the ends of the bar magnet or magnet is a pole strength. Understand? Then how it will? What are the units to measure? Units are measured to what? What is ampere meter? Units to measure pole strength. Is what a ampere meter. Ampere is what a unit to measure the electric current. Ampere is the unit to measure the electric current. So that about we will discuss in the next lesson. Okay. Coming to that, before we discuss what a geometric length and also magnetic length. Length is measured by meters. So it is showing by units what a ampere and the meter. That hyphen showing multiplication in the units. Ampere meter is the unit to measure the pole strength. Showing by the symbol small m. Okay. And coming to that, one more we learn about what characters of the pole strength is. What are the factors? It depends on only what a length of the magnet. Length of the magnet and the cross section of the magnet. Length of the magnet and the cross section of the magnet. Cross section is area of the magnet. And also magnetic field, strength of the magnetic field of the magnet. Means up to around the magnet, how much it shows the magnetic force. So that field we are saying magnetic field of the magnet. So that by the factors only goes on. The force is depend on those particular characters. So because of the strength will show the force in the region of the magnet depends on the what cross section area of the magnet and the length of the magnet. So those three are what factors of the those are characters of the pulley. Depends on the force depends on those three parts, which is one is length of the magnet, second one area of the magnet means cross section of the magnet, third one is field of the magnet, magnetic field. So and next one, magnetic moment. Magnetic moment. Magnetic moment. It is showing by the symbol capital M. Before pole strength was shown by small m. Now we are showing magnetic moment with capital M. Magnetic moment. Moment. Magnetic moment is a product of poles them and magnetic length, magnetic length. So what I'm saying to you, product of poles and magnetic length, which is the magnetic moment. So how to write those? Yeah, see there, magnetic moment, what you are saying? Product of pole strength and magnetic length. So, product of pole strength and magnetic length, what, how we can write? Pole strength means what I said? Pole strength means what? The ability of the attraction or repulsion. Attraction or repulsion of ends of the magnet. Ends of the magnet. So that is the pole strength. Understand? Magnetic length means what I said. Magnetic length means what I said to you. Pole strength means we discussed. Right? Magnetic means the distance between the poles. The distance between the poles. Pole strength shown by symbol is what is small n. Magnetic length is shown by the 2L. Now magnetic moment m is equal to magnetic moment m is equal to pole strength. Product law means multiplication into magnetic length. Magnetic length. So magnetic moment capital M is equal to pole strength small m. Magnetic length is a 2L. So it is measured by magnetic moment measured by what? Pole strength. Pole strength units are what? Ampere, meter. Into magnetic length is measured by meters. So it is measured by ampere meter square. Ampere meter square. Ampere square of the meter is the unit to measure magnetic moment. Okay, pole strength measured by ampere meter. Magnetic length is measured by meter. Understand? This is general information about magnetic moment and the pole strength. Then, okay, do you have idea on this? Coming to that, so we are going to now talk about to section of the magnet, means to divide the magnet, to cut the magnet, to break the magnet as vertical. Vertical means perpendicular. Okay, vertical. This is the vertical. This is horizontal. Okay, this is vertical, this is horizontal. Understand? So vertically and horizontal. So I am going to draw you for magnet. Bar magnet, this is. Okay. I am writing to you poles. What is this? South pole. And you say this is a north pole. Okay. See that if you divide any magnet as a tiny parts, already discussed, you break the magnet into tiny parts, that tiny parts of the magnet also act as an individual magnet. Means that a tiny part of the break a tiny part of the magnet also act as a is what an actual magnet. Means it shows a pair of poles. That a tiny part of the magnet also shows a pair of poles. Means it shows as a magnet. Understand? Same as now we are going to section of the magnet. Vertical section and the horizontal section. Vertical section and the horizontal section. See there. Now I am going to make the horizontal section. Horizontal section. So by that I am making horizontal section. How many parts I made? Horizontally 1, 2, 3, 4 I made. 4 parts I made as a horizontal of the magnet. Means now I am saying number of parts made by what? Horizontal. Horizontal cutting of a bar magnet. No, it is like that. Then see that. Now I'm saying, just imagine if I made number of parts here. Just imagine, no need to think about work. I'm saying I made number of parts from n number of parts. N means what? Something number. Okay, number of parts from n I made n. Okay, then coming to here, then what about pole strength and what about magnetic moment and what about magnetic moment and magnetic length? See there, what about those? Now I made it here, magnetic length. Magnetic length is 2L and what is next? Pole strength. What is that? Pole strength and magnetic moment. Magnetic moment shown by capital M. Understand? Then see here, what I'm saying to you, this is one, this is one, this is one. Understand? So magnetic length, pole strength, and magnetic moment. How these three will be by the number of parts are making to the bar magnet. Understand? By dividing the bar magnet, by cutting the bar magnet, how those three will be changed? How those three will be changed? See there, bar magnet length is this is. Okay, I made a cutting hole in horizontal breaking of the magnet. What happened? The length will be same now. The length will be same. Length is same or not? Length does not change because I made what? Horizontal. Horizontal. So length is same. So that's why magnetic length is remains same. Remains same. When magnet when horizontal cutting, horizontal breaking, the length is same, magnetic. Then pole strength. Then what about pole strength? Huh? Pole strength, what happened? See there. Pole strength is changed or not? The pole is divided into number of parts. Pole is divided into number of parts. Then what you have to find? New pole strength is actual pole strength by actual pole strength by number of parts. Number of parts. Actual pole strength is what? M. Actual pole strength is what? M. And the number of parts? M. Number of parts? M. Is it? The magnetic moment. Pole strength has changed. Is it or not? Pole strength is changed or not? Then magnetic moment also changing. Is it? That's why you have to write new magnetic moment. New magnetic moment. How like it is? Actual magnetic moment by number of parts. Number of parts. So by that we can write. So actual magnetic moment M means what you can magnetic moment what I said? Product of the pole strength and the magnetic length. So that's why small m into 2L by number of parts. Understand? Okay. Then by vertical section. By vertical section. By vertical section means by making number of parts by this. Before horizontal you made 4 parts, no? We can utilize it. Number of means 4. Okay. Now I said n, no, that's why I use it here. Then by making vertically. By making vertical break of the bar magnet. Breaking of the bar magnet. Then poles will be remain same, no? length is changing. Length is changing. So that's why you can write what a magnetic length is. Magnetic length is how like a, it is going to magnetic length. New magnetic length is actual magnetic length by number of parts. Because of length change, now you divide by tiny parts. And the pole strength is same because of pole does not change by each part. That's why pole strength remains same. Remains same. The magnetic moment. How many parts are made by vertical section? Number of parts of magnetic moment by number of parts. So by that we have to identify pole strength and the magnetic moment. Okay. Then we start one question based on that. The length of the magnet is 16 centimeter. Its pole strength is 250 milli ampere meter. Milli ampere meter. What is it when it is cut into four equal parts? Four equal parts. Four equal parts. As parallel to axis of a magnet, then what is the new magnetic length pole strength and magnetic moment? What is our question? The length of the magnet is 16 centimeter. Its pole strength is 250 milli ampere meter. When it is cut into four equal parts as a parallel to axis of a magnet, then what is the new magnetic length, pole strength, and the magnetic moment? How can you find those? Can you find that? First, you have to remember what they are given to us. The length of the magnet is magnetic length given. So what they given, we will write our code. Okay. Given magnetic length. Magnetic length. They given here. So I am writing sharp notation. Yeah. Magnetic length, how much they given? 16 centimeter. 16 centimeter. And one more they given to you. Pole strength. Now they given pole strength. So we write that. You get another? Pole strength. So showing by small m that they given how much? 250 milli ampere meter. Milli ampere meter. Then when it cut into four equal parts, then when it cut four equal parts, number of parts is equal to number of parts. Number of parts is equal to how many? Four. Number of food parts, how many? Four, four, by horizontally. And then what you have to find, how they made parallel to axis. Parallel to axis. Parallel to axis means how, like, this is a magnet. They made by this way. Parallel to axis. Axis means the line which is passing horizontal to the magnet, diameter of the magnet. So horizontally they made. So by making horizontally, what is a magnetic length? Magnetic length is same one, you know. So we can say magnetic length is remains same. What is the answer for that? By making horizontal cutting, the magnetic length is remains same. Remains same. Means 16 centimeter. Okay. Then pole strength. Magnetic length will be written. So pole strength you have to find. Pole strength. Then what is the pole strength? Pole as divided now has the same as number of poles. That's right. New pole strength. New pole strength. Is equal to new pole strength is equal actual pole strength by number of parts. Actual pole strength, how much they give at here? 250 milli. This we have to change. 250 in the milli means 10 power minus 3 have to change. And ampere meter. So into 10 power minus 3. Ampere meter by number of parts, how many they divided? 4. How many? 4. So by that we can write. Otherwise, no, if you no need to write that, you can press really that problem. Okay. So we press like only really. 4 ones are 250. How much time? So 4 6 are 24. Take 1, how much you can get there? 1, 0. 4 2s are 8, and then 2, make this one 5. 4 5s are 20. So, 62.5 milli ampere meter. This is a new pole strength. Then, what you have to find next? Magnetic moment. So, magnetic moment, how to find it? Magnetic moment actually was a new magnetic moment. Magnetic moment means product of pole strength and magnetic moment. So new magnetic moment is actual pole strength into magnetic length by number of parts. So actual pole strength, how much? 250 milli ampere meter into magnetic length is what? 16. Yeah, 16 centimeters. So about 16 centimeters, we have to change into what? Meters. We have with meters now. So that's coming to that. 16 into centimeter. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. Okay, then 1 centimeter is equal to 0.01 meters. Means we can write 10 power minus 2 meters. So 10 power minus 2 meters because of, we can write this is 0.01 means 1 by 100. Right? 100 upside. 10 power minus 2. Okay, then write that 60 meter tempo minus 2 meters, and here by number of parts spoke. This will be right into what? 10 power minus 3. So from this, for 1s are 4, 4s are. Okay? For 0, 0, for 5s are 20, for 2s are 8 and 10. Is that enough? For 0, 0, 4, 5, 20, 4, 10. And into 10 power minus 3, into 10 power minus 2. And the ampere meter square, ampere meter square, units came from the magnetic moment. So, then I said 3 zeros, those will be cancelled. Then 10 power minus 2 ampere meter square means you can write 0.01 ampere meter square for what you got there. Okay, this is a new magnetic moment, a new magnetic force, that is magnetic length. This is where you solve the problems. Okay then, remain what is there, we will talk in the next class. So we will see in next class and stay in line, stay in online. Next mathematics madam will come to your class. Please, in online, don't disconnect you.